Welcome to the lecture. Today we will be looking at constructs that allow you to better code your C++ program. Luckily, C++ provides a couple of new concepts that ease programming and allow you to make sure that the code is easier to maintain, better to understand, and so forth. So those concepts are, for example, encapsulation and how they interacts with friendly functions. Then we will look at exception handling, that means how we can handle exceptional errors. Then we look at typecasting, and lastly at constant data members and member functions. So encapsulation means one of the key principles of object orientation. In terms of a programmer that uses an interface, they should see in the interface what is needed, nothing more, nothing less. That's useful, for example, when you document a header file using DoxyGen, and from such a documentation, the user would be able to understand, grasp how this is used, similar to our C++.com illustration of the standard template library. We should certainly hide the implementation details, which allows us to change the classes depending on different implementations. An implementation might be better suited for a certain hardware, for example, so it might be more performant than another one. So this increases maintainability because it loses the coupling between the user of an API and the implementation. How can we actually implement this? Well, we have to declare data members protected or private, sensibly, and avoid any public data members, except when they are absolutely needed. There are friendly functions that allow, and friendly classes that can access private members selectively. So that means I first forbid everyone to access, and then I enable selected kind of methods or classes to access my private members as needed. Let's look at an example for a friendly function. So assume you have a function that does something for class A and the class B objects. So maybe you need now to do this function, you need to implement it, you need some kind of private members from A and B. The problem is that such a function cannot be stored in class A easily because it needs class B as well. And it cannot store it in class B because it needs the private private members or private methods from class A as well. So therefore, friendly classes allow us to give access to another class to treat private and access private and protected members, such as it would be methods from our own class. So I could store this function, for example, now externally somewhere and make it friend to class A and class B. That way, this function can access the private members, which are data members or the functions. So let's have a look at an example. So if we want to determine if a rectangle is inscribable in a circle, we can have a function that says inscribed that returns 1 if the rectangle fits exactly inside the circle. So we have here a rectangle type and a circle class type. Those two should fit in each other. So we now make this function friend to both circle and rectangle class. But let's have a look at this problem first. How can we inscribe a rectangle in a circle? So this is the example. So we have here a circle, and now we try to put a rectangle inside. There's a mathematical equation that checks if a rectangle can be inscribed in such a circle, and it exactly yields if this equation, so the left-hand side of the equation is identical to the right-hand side. It's basically Pythagoras' theorem. Have a look at this. So now what we can do, we have to declare, of course, our circle class. So we have a header, and in this one we include mathematical functions here from C. In this class, we first of all do a forward declaration. We say rectangle is another class that we know of. And then we say class circle is now a shape. So it inherits from a shape class. And has as private members a radius, x and y position, and a circle area. And as public, it has a constructor that allows you to put in those values, and a function that allows you to return the area under the circle. Now we want to make it friend, so we do this by saying friend inscribed, and well, this kind of keyword friend needs to be placed between the return type and the name of the function. So we want to make this function int inscribed to be friend to this circle class. This function will take rectangle R and a circle R C. That's why we actually had to do this forward declaration here. Now the compiler at link time will make sure that it links to the rectangle class such that this code kind of works. Okay, now we basically allow this friend function to access our private members. Let's have a look at the rectangle class. Well, it's kind of really analogous. So it also has its friend to inscribe, but it needs circle, forward declaration for circle, and so on. A slightly different private data members. Yeah, it has also area function, because that's declared in our shape. Now let's have a look at our inscribed function. This one takes rectangle and a circle. It needs the respective header files. Now we basically now implement this check from the left and the right hand side for Pythagoras theorem. So if, you know, this is the check over here, if diagonal radius equals C, which is the circle, radius times circle radius. So what is diag radius? Well, this is kind of our equation over here, which was the right hand side of this. So yeah, also we check if the center of them makes sense. So that's this left check, so it's an additional check which we could have or not. Yeah, so as you can see, what we access CX, CY, and we access diagonal members such as radius. So this works. It is a way of friend. Friends need to be used really sensitively. You can't just have you shouldn't put hundreds of friends, functions or classes inside a class definition, because it's just too much. Yeah, and it would be overwhelming, it would not be useful. So you would do this very selectively in your code. Yeah, let's have a look at the main function that actually uses now our new objects. So we allow someone to input coordinates for a rectangle, then we input the radius and coordinates for a circle. We create a rectangle box and a circle disk variable here is the respective inputs from the user. And then we check if it's inscribable the box object into the disk object. And then we make a proper output over here.